Hey, what's up, you guys? So today, I don't really know what to call this, but I looked up a bunch of like random questions. I don't know. So this is kind of like a random questions tag, but I have two lists that I'm gonna be going through because some of these questions are like really weird and like don't go with how I am. I don't know, they don't really apply to me or anything. So I looked up two lists and I'm going to go through them and answer random questions about me because I haven't done like a get to know me any type of video thing since like a while ago. I think the only other video that I did about me was the TMI tag, and that was so long ago. That was when my hair was like down to here. I had brown hair, bleached tips, like a while ago. So that's what we're doing today. So let's just get started. All right, we can either do like the fun ones first or the deep ones first. I think we should start off with the fun ones first and then get a little more serious. All right, so what's your favorite candle scent? I'm not really a candle person. Candles scare me. That's why I can't have candles in my room. I think I actually have a fake candle. Hold on, let me see. Lay down. I have this. This is from my graduation, so there's actually graduation stuff here. There's like cards that are like words of wisdom, and then confetti, and then here's a candle. I don't know if it has batteries in it. Oh, it does! Look, I have a fake candle now. I should like put this in the background and be like, look, I'm a real YouTuber. I didn't know it had batteries in it. Don't mind all of my drinks. I have drinks. Do y'all like my candle? No, I don't do candles because I'm paranoid that they're going to like catch on fire and burn my whole house down. Like, it's fine if it's like downstairs, like on a table, but I don't trust myself like in my bedroom or anything. But if I had to pick favorite scent of somebody else's candle, I would probably go with like, I don't know, like cupcakes or vanilla. I don't know. I'm not really into candles. What female celebrity do you wish was your sister? Rydell Lynch, because she, okay, way back in like, I don't even know, maybe like 2013 or 14, her style was amazing. It was like so bright, so funky. It was like everything that is me, like literally. And it would be so fun if she was my sister to like steal things from her closet, and she's just a happy person. What male celebrity do you wish was your brother? Definitely Riker, because I know he would be protective of me. And like, since I don't have any siblings, like I don't have anyone to protect me, so I don't know. How old do you think you'll be when you get married? I honestly have no idea. Maybe like, I don't know, 26? I don't know, that's just a random guess. Do you know a hoarder? Me. Do I count? I know you guys have all seen my room cleaning videos. Can you do a split? No, I am like the most non-flexible person ever. We used to do these things for gym class, and it was part of like fitness training. And you'd have to like reach over, like have your hands like this, see how far you could reach over. I barely got like anything because I'm like so not flexible. How old were you when you learned to ride a bike? I honestly have no idea. Maybe like 8? I don't know. All I remember is that like I would have one of my parents like holding on to the back of the seat and one of my handlebars, and like I would not let them let go. What is my favorite candy? Probably Sweet Tarts. I'm actually eating Sweet Tarts, like literally. I love anything like fruity, sour. I love sour stuff. Fruity, sour, anything like that. I'm not really a big chocolate person, but I do like chocolate. My favorite chocolate is probably Hershey's. I don't know. That's kind of like the only chocolate I guess I eat. I'm more into fruity things. How many oceans have you swam in? Just the Atlantic. How many countries have you been to? All right, I'm not sure on this one. because I've never left the US except for on a cruise. And I don't know what countries those islands were part of, or I don't know. We went to San Juan, St. Martin, St. Thomas, and something else, Tortola. So if any of those are not US territories or something, then I've been there, but never been anywhere else. So what's the worst grade you got on a test? All right, well, I never usually get bad grades, except for when I was in geometry in ninth grade. My teacher sucked. He gave us the easiest homework and the easiest practice examples, and then he gave us the hardest quizzes. And we were in honors class, and by the end of the first semester, almost the whole class was failing. And it's an honors class should not be pretty much failing. He was such a bad teacher. So probably, I don't know, probably the lowest grade I got was 42. I don't know, maybe lower than that. I don't remember. I just remember I hated that class because we had such a bad teacher. Have you read any of the Harry Potter, Hunger Games, or Twilight series? I've read 5.5 of the Harry Potter books, seen all the movies, and I was gonna read Twilight. I had the first book, then I didn't, and then I watched, I think, the first one, or maybe the first and second one, but I wasn't really into the whole series, so no, and never read or seen the Hunger Games. Do you spell the color as G-R-E-Y or G-R-A-Y? I'm always so conflicted, literally. This is such a weird question, but I have, asked myself this, too. It's how do you spell the color gray? Really, though. I think I usually spell it G-R-A-Y, but I used to spell it G-R-E-Y, but then I was oh, that's not correct. It's G-R-A-Y. I don't know. All right. The truth comes out. How do you spell gray? I'm trusting Crayola, so however they spell it, that's what I'm gonna start writing it as. G-R-A-Y. See? Yes. Good. All right. That answers that question. Also, yes, I am wearing pajamas. Don't kill me. I like to be comfy. Do you know triplets? Yes, I do. Do you prefer Titanic or The Notebook? Is it bad if I've never seen either? Literally. I've read a book about the Titanic, but not the storyline that is the Titanic. I read about it was a factual book about the exact events that happened, but I haven't seen either. What would your parents have named you if you were the opposite gender? My parents would have named me Ian. And it's actually funny because there was this guy on this show that I liked, and his name was Ian, and he was really cute. If you have a nickname, what is it? All right. I have a nickname, and it's, sort of weird, but I can, explain where it came from. So, way back when, there were these things called Webkinz. I don't know if any of you know what that is, but a Webkinz was basically, a little stuffed animal. And it came with a code, and you could play with it online. And I had so many of these things. But my username was Kygar, and then my mom and dad got accounts, and they were Momgar and Dadgar. And there is this one episode of SpongeBob where they go back to prehistoric times, and it's SpongeGar, and that's kind of how it came to be. So, I don't know. Nobody really calls me that anymore. Sometimes my cousin calls me that, but I don't know. People don't really call me by my nickname. They just call me Kylie. Who's your favorite person in the world? Is that even a question? It's Riker Lynch. All the way. Would you rather live in a rural area or in the suburbs? I think I kind of live, between those two. Maybe it's more the suburbs. I don't know. I always thought it would be cool to live on a farm, but then again, it'd be so much work. I don't know. I guess kind of where I live now, I think it's kind of suburb-ish. Yeah. Can you whistle? I can, but I can only whistle, one solid note. I can't do different pitches. Hold on, let's see if I can whistle now. I'm all hold on, okay, hold on. I don't know. This is the best I can do. I can't really whistle. It's just one solid pitch. I'm not good. I'm not talented. Do you eat breakfast every morning? No, not usually. Do you take any pills or medication daily? I take Lexapro, which is for anxiety. What medical conditions do you have? I don't know if this is considered a condition necessarily, but I get kidney stones. Not fun. What's the last compliment you got? I think it was something like, hey, cute selfie. I don't know, something like that. It was on Snapchat, so. Do you usually remember your dreams in the morning? All the time, every single day, yes. What flavor tea do you enjoy? None. I hate tea, and I don't like, this is my thing. I think this is why I don't like tea. I don't like watered down stuff, so even like if I have like lemonade or like, you know, like, it's fine if it's like Kool-Aid that you like buy, but if it's like a mix and you like put in the powder and then the water, if there's not enough like powder in it and it's too watery, I won't like it. So I feel like I don't like tea because it's too watered down. So, all right, now we're moving on to the serious questions. I don't know. Love with heartbreaks or no love at all? Probably love with heartbreaks, because then at least you get the happiness at first, at least. I don't know. Which one do you prefer, trust or love, and why? Well, I don't know if this is referring to being in love, because, I mean, single Pringle right here. but probably trust, because you can love someone and they can be really not trustworthy, and like they could cheat on you. I don't know, I feel like I would pick trust just because, no, it feels safer. Is money the real source of happiness? What makes you happy? Way back when I was in 10th grade, I started a YouTube channel because I found out, hey, you can make money. And it takes a long time for you to get any money at all, especially if you're starting out. Like, so it started out being, okay, I'm gonna start a YouTube channel, I'm gonna make money. But over the years, it's more turned into, this is a really fun thing. Like, YouTube is my happy place, and like, this is where I come if I'm having a rough day or anything. I don't know, YouTube is just my happy place, and YouTube makes me happy, and friends make me happy, and music makes me happy. So, any of those make me happy. What is probably the hardest thing to lose in your case? Why is it hard to give up? They mean like an actual thing or just anything, because if it's anything, it would be my cat, because she's my best friend and she's always with me, and I love her, and I love cats. Cats are by far my favorite animal. Imagine you are alone at home, lonely and bored. Me every day. Who would you like slash wish to be together with? Well, I usually never have any friends over because most of my friends are internet friends and I live very far away. But if I could have anyone with me, I'll do anyone or people that I know. Any of my friends would be fun to have, because most of them I've never seen in person. And if I could have anyone, like anyone ever, Riker. If there is one time or one moment in the last year or month that you would change, what moment would it be and why? I don't know. That's actually a really hard question. Because, I don't know, I don't really do things I regret, I guess. I'm a safe person. Can't think of anything. When did you last honestly reveal your feelings to someone else, no matter how hard it was to tell? Who was it? Why did you tell the person? I've never had a boyfriend, so doesn't really apply to me, I guess. I don't know who else besides a boyfriend I would reveal my feelings to. I don't know. I mean, I talk with like my friends about who I like, and I don't know. I guess if that counts, then I was talking to Becca because I saw Becca recently, and she's one of my closest friends, and I don't know. I was telling her who I like, but I don't know. Does that count? I don't know. I almost did to an actual guy. I don't know. I almost did once, but then I didn't. Your best friend just confesses to having feelings to you and wants you to be more than usual friends. This phrase is so weird. Usual friends. Like, as opposed to what? he/she loves you. Well, it would be he. What will you do or say? Well, considering I've never dated anyone before, I would probably say yes, just because, I don't know, I've never dated anyone before. And I feel like if I dated a friend, it's like, okay, I already know who it is, so it's not like, oh, this could be anybody, they could be a criminal, like, I don't know, you get what I'm saying? It's like, if it was a friend, then, like, I would know who they are, so I would probably trust them already, and, like, I don't know, I'd probably say yes, like, I don't know, that's a weird question. When heading to work, you encounter a situation that you need to help out. Is that English? For instance, a cat is stuck on top of a tree. Your boss has threatened to fire you if you get late to work again. So written weird. Do you risk saving the cat's life? Why not? If it was this specific situation, and it was a cat, yes. Because I love cats. Like, cats are, like, everything. I love cats so much. So if it was a cat, yes. If it was something else, probably not. Alright, so that concludes this video. I don't know. There were just a bunch of random questions about me. I feel like this was a good video to make just because I haven't really done any of these, like, about me type videos. I don't know. So, in case you were curious about any of those things, there you go. So I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, or if you have any other questions, I might do a Q&A sometime. Maybe. Possibly. So if you have any Q&A questions, comment down below. Leave me a big thumbs up if you enjoyed. Subscribe if you're new. Follow me on any craziness I might be up to. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!